So, dear students, today we are going to do exercise 2.2 questions. Exercise 2.2, and we are on question number 3. If you remember, question number 1 and 2 in 6C, I will teach those questions tomorrow. And I would request everyone to please be alert and write it down everything in your classwork copy. Now, the first question of question number 3 is. 297 into 17 plus 297 into 3. Now, if you will see this question is related to distributive property. If you must be knowing, I have taught this property to you. This question is related to distributive property. And what you have to do it here? You have to solve this question by using the property. How will you do that? Always remember, in this case, you will just take out what is common in both. Okay? You will just take out what is common in both. Like you have two terms, one term is this, one term is this. So you will always take out the thing which is common. Now, what is common over here? 297 is common over here. And one more thing which you will find it out which is common over here. That is multiply sign. The sign of multiply is also common. So what you will take out, you will also take out the sign of multiply common. Now after taking out this sign common, you will find that what will be left over here, you have taken out 297, you have taken out multiply sign common, you have only left 17 over here, then plus, and you have left with here only 3. Okay, so now 297 multiply by 17 plus 3. Now what will you do now? 297 will remain like this only. The sign of multiply will remain like this only. And then 17 and 3 will give you over here 20. Now after 20, you will just multiply these two. How will you multiply? 0 will remain 0 only. 2 sevens are 14. Carry here 1, 2 9s are 18, 18 1 19, carry here 1, 2 2s are 4, 4 plus 1 5. So the answer of this question will be 5940. Okay, the answer of this question will be 5940. So yes, absolutely correct students. How will you do that? You will just take it out the common number. The common number is 887 in both the terms. And second thing is the sign of multiply also. So I will also take it out the sign of multiply common. When you will take it out both the things common, you will get it 1002 minus 2. Now when you will take it out these things common, you will get it 887 multiply by 1002 minus 2, you will get it 1000 only. And when you will multiply these two numbers, you will get it 887000. This is the solution, complete solution for this particular question. Now, as you all can see, students, this is the question number 30, which has three numbers in one term, no? So what you are going to do, you will be first group this number, and after grouping these two numbers, you are getting after multiply 19225 multiply by 782. I have written like this. Now, plus, when you are multiplying this two, again you are getting 19225 into 218. Now when you will multiply this thing, you will get it. You will get it this thing. Okay, you will get it this thing. Now what you will see? You will just see that when you will multiply these two numbers, you will get it. This number is common in both the terms. 19225, you will get it common in both. So when you will do it 19225 common, you will get it 782 plus 218. Now when you will multiply This one you are getting it 19225. Some of these students are getting one. Okay. So, beta, after multiplying, you've got it 19225 here also, 19225 here also. So, you have taken it common. And the sign of multiply also, you have taken it common. Now, what is left? 782 and this side 218. Okay? Now, when you will add these two, you will get it 1000. Now, multiply by 19225. Now, when you will multiply these two, you will get it 19225000. This will be the answer for this particular question. Now, this is the question which is question number 4. This is the question which is from NCERT. I took it from NCERT. And this is the question which I took it from R.S. Agarwal or R.D. Sharma, I can tell. Okay, this is the question related to R.D. Sharma, I can say. Or R.S. Agarwal also you can assume because this is not given in NCERT. This is an extra question. Now, what you have to do? You have to just think out of these two numbers. Please be alert on your chat box. Please be alert on your chat box. Okay? Now, just see this. And in this number, which number can be broken up into some parts which will be easier for us to understand? Like in this 103, which you can break like 100 plus 3. Okay, 100 plus 3. So can you tell me in this number, which number can you break in the form of 100 or 1000 or something like that? Please look at the second question and reply, which number can you break here? Tell me, which more easier way? Second question. Look at here, beta. Out of these numbers, this number will be more convenient to break. How it can be broken up? It can be written like 1000 minus 1. It can also be written 900 plus 99. But you only tell me which is more comfortable to you. Tell me which number is, which breaking part is more comfortable? This one or this one? You only tell me. I'm not telling. You only decide which is more easy. First one or second one? Very good. Correct. Yes, right. I want every one of you to please reply in the chat box. Which one is more easy? We can also break it like this. We can also break it like this. But which one is more easy? You can find it. The first one is more easy for you to solve. So remember, we can take the first one. Okay, now look at here, 891 multiply by 1000 minus 1. Now, we have written like this. Now, you have to just use the property which we have already studied earlier. That was Changu Mangu Samosa Chutney. Now, what we will do? We will just open this bracket and apply the property. How will you apply? 738 multiply by 100 plus 738 multiply by 3. The same will be going here also. How will you do that? 891 multiply by 1000 minus 891 into 1. The same process we are doing at a time two questions. Okay? Now, just solve it. It will give you 738 00 plus 8 3s are 24, carry here 2, 3 3s are 9, 9 2 11, carry here 1, 3 7s are 21, 21 and 1 22. This is 2 2 1 4. Now let us solve this question. 891 multiply by 1000, which will give you 891 with 000, and then minus 891 into 1, which will give you 891 only. Now I have written this. Now let us add, and in that question let us subtract and see what answer do you get in this case. Now here you will get it 738 00. Adding to 2214 which will give you 41016, and this is this 76014. This is our answer for this particular question. Finished. Answer. Okay, let us see this question now. 891000 minus 891. Now let us subtract this. Now when you will subtract this, it will give you 10. This will give you 9. This will give you 9. This will give you 0. So here it will give you 10 में से 1, it will give you 9. 9 में से 9, it will give you 0. 9 में से 8, it will give you 1. Now here it will give you 0 only. This will give you 9. This will give you 8. 890109. Finish. Yes. So question number 5 is, a taxi driver filled his car petrol tank इसने गलत लिखा हुआ है क्वेश्चन में थोड़ा. A taxi driver filled his car with petrol by petrol tank with 40 liters of petrol on Monday. It means on Monday the driver has filled 40 liters of petrol. ठीक है, 40 liters of petrol on Monday. ठीक है. Now the next thing is the next day. The next day means Tuesday. So the next day means Tuesday now. Now on Tuesday he has filled the same car tank with 50 liters of petrol. Next day usne complete kiya 50 liters of petrol. Now if petrol cost rupees 44 per liter, how much did he spend in all on the petrol? Now see this question. If you will see, on Monday total petrol was used, that was 40 liter. On Tuesday the total petrol which was used, that was 50 liter. And the cost of 1 liter petrol was 44. So if you want to find it out, the total cost of petrol filled on Monday, it will be 40 multiplied by 44. Okay, do not solve it. Yes, do not solve it. Only let it be written like that. 40 into 44. Do not solve it further. Just write it like this only. We will use property. It will be solved very easily. Okay? So this will be now total cost of petrol filled on Monday. That will be 40 into 44. Now the same thing. Total cost of petrol filled on Tuesday, because Monday ke baad we will find it out for Tuesday. Can you guess what will be for Tuesday? Please type in the chat box. Yes, correct. Here it will be rupees 50 multiply by 44. 50 multiply by 44. Now let us find it out. Total cost of petrol on Monday and Tuesday. हम लोग दोनों दिन का निकाल रहे हैं, ठीक है? For Monday and Tuesday, both of the days we are taking out. How will you do that then? 40 into 44 plus 50 into 44. Okay, 40 into 44, 50 into 44. Now tell me, which property is this which we have just now studied? Write it down in the chat box. Which property is this right now? Have you ever solved this type of property? Isse pehle ki aapne aisi property solve ki hai? Yes, very good. This is distributive property. What can be taken out common? What can be taken out common? Write it down in the chat box. क्या निकल सकता है common यहाँ से? What can be common? Very good, very nice. 44 can be common. And the sign of multiply can be common. Now what will be left inside? What will be left inside, beta? What will be the left? What will be left inside? Very good, correct. 40 plus 50. 40 plus 50 will be left inside, and it will give you 44 into 40 plus 50, which will be added together, will give you 90. Will give you 90. Correct. Will give you 90. Now just you need to multiply rupees, because you are finding out the cost, so it will give you rupees. Zero will remain zero only. 9 fours are 36. Carry here 3. 9 fours are 36. 36 and 3, 39. So the answer of this question will be rupees 3,960 rupees. The total cost of petrol filled on his in his petrol tank. Multiplying the cost, beta. Suppose you have one pen you have purchased and the cost is 5 rupees, but you want two pens. So what will you do? 2 fives are 10. 10 rupees pen aa jayega. If you want 3 pen, you will multiply 3 with 5. If you have 4 pen, you will take it out 4 into 5. So here the same thing, the total liters of petrol were 40. So we are multiplying 40 with 44. If petrol will be 50, then 50 will be 44 with multiply will be 44. Dear students, remember the next question is match the following. And in match the following, the first answer is distributive property, because it is showing the distributive property here. The second one was commutative property under multiplication, because it is showing the multiplication only. And the third match the following answer will be commutative property again, but not multiplication. This time it will be addition, because it is showing the addition one. Okay, so remember these answers. The first one is distributive, the second one is commutative under multiplication, and the third one is commutative under addition.